Hi friends, this is Agnelorajesh here, chairman for St. Angelos VNCT Ventures. We are India's largest villa developers, developing villas at Thane, Chennai, Madurai, Coimbatore and Hyderabad. Advantage of buying villas with us is, we give you rental returns after you buy the villa and the maintenance is zero. You don't have to put money nor efforts to maintain the villa. Where progressive rental returns ensures that after you buy the villa, EMI or the loan repayment for the villa is offset by the rental returns that we generate. For more details, visit us on www.savvglobal.com.
You know, there's a process of reverse mentoring. Not only they learn from you, we can learn from anyone, but I learned from when I met you, I learned some things from you. See, I think the biggest thing is to free time. My biggest challenge is to have clean time. And then when you're in the business and if you love what you do, you get your business. At the end of it, it's about the person. You find ideas, but you want find the person at the start with the idea. I believe in prarabdha. I believe in things are preordained. We don't know, so we make efforts. God, some relationships are so good, and suddenly, you know, something happens. So, you know, again, I feel whatever happens, I've got to a point where I believe whatever happens, happens for good.
Good morning, friends, and today we are on the 46th session of Inspiring Conversations. This is the second Dr. Batra on the board. Before this, we have done a session with Dr. Mukesh Batra. In spite of he being the second Dr. Batra, but he is the first person in the sector of media and entertainment. And as a concept of Inspiring Conversations, we have never repeated a sector. And today the sector is media and entertainment. So I would like to request Dr. Batra to come up and join me. And we'll have a short conversation of almost 15-20 minutes. And we suggest all of you to ask questions to him related to the sector that he's operating in. So media as a business. Dr. Annurag Batra is a phenomenal personality, very well known in the media sector and the entertainment sector. His network is more dense than the Indian Railways. Indian Railways is supposed to have the best network in the world. I think Dr. Annurag Batra and relationships will cross that also. He's a very dear friend and fastest fingers fast is his motto in life. Even as he's listening to me, he's typing a message to somebody. I'm sure he's typing the content that I'm saying. And we will come to know this personality in the next few minutes. The objective is, the idea of Inspiring Conversations is to learn from the experiences and exposures of others. The people who have been there and done that. So Dr. Annurag Batra is one such personality. So can we get started, sir?
Thank you, Agnalu, for those kind words. I'm not sure I'm all that, but I don't even have the voice that you were talking. I lost my voice because of fatigue. But I'm here. You invited me. I met him last Sunday. I was in Bombay. Then he sent me a text and I have to be in Bombay today for something. So it worked out. God makes things happen. So I'm happy to be here. And, you know, he just caught my signature and said, we're going to analyze your signature.
On camera. So we're going to be unrobing you.
Yeah. I mean, those are my words to him privately, but thank you for being so transparent with people. Sometimes it's a good virtue, but God made two kinds of people, actually four kinds of people. To some he gave hair, the others he gave brain. To me he gave none, no hair, no brains. And people like Agnello, both hair and brains. So, you know, hair are overrated. Thank you. You know, introductions can be very flattering. My ear has written it. And then I also keep adding stuff to it. But like all of us, I am trying to stay healthy, happy, and hopefully spend less time on my screen.
So that's a very interesting journey that Dr. Annurag Batra has. He is a first generation entrepreneur. He is a son to parents who are teachers. So that gives him a very interesting background. And he is an accidental entrepreneur. Why accidental means? He didn't plan to become an entrepreneur, but today is a very successful entrepreneur. Exchange for Media has been a game changer in the zone of media. And Exchange for Media is a company and a platform which Dr. Annurag Batra started. And today he also owns a very series of lifestyle magazines called Business World. So that also is a brainchild of Dr. Annurag Batra. What we want to talk to you about is Dr. Annurag Batra as an entrepreneur in the sector of media and entertainment. So as entrepreneurs, we face challenges and we have solutions and we have roadmaps that we need to follow the way we achieve our goals. We want to understand from successful people like you on what did you do to make what has happened to you till today, how we can implement that in our businesses. So that is the core objective behind Inspiring Conversations. As a first generation entrepreneur, when you got into entrepreneurship, I'm sure you must have had planned setbacks. You would have planned something and something else would have happened. Along the way, how did you fine tune your journey to your plans? If you can come a little.
Thank you, Agnelo. You know, first of all, you know, I come from a middle class background, just to give you, you know, the introductions are very cameras. So I did what most Indians do before they do anything, at least from my age. So I went to an engineering school. Because when I was in 10th, you know, my parents told me that if I had started till 12, and I did okay and went into engineering school, I don't have to worry, and I can have a good time. So in my engineering school, I had a good time. I will not go into that. But I just want to give you one statistic, and I'm not glorifying not studying. I don't glorify that anymore. In the third year, we had 44 subjects with viva, practical, written. I flunked in 39, so I think that's a record difficult to beat, but I did recover it in the fourth year. Well, I'm paranoid, I'm okay. And just that I was having too much fun, you know, went to the hostel for the first time. And then I'm a very lucky person, and I really mean that. I got into a business school. From the first batch of that business school, I got in when the quality control was bad. Have you heard of a school called MDI? What does it stand for? Like people tell me, I love reading books. So I ask them, which is the book you read last? Blast. So sometimes, you know, they go into a trance. But do you know what is the full form of MDI? It's not that mentally deformed individuals, but it's Management Development Institute, right? I ask that because a lot of people still don't know. In West, I mean, it's the 48th year of the school. My magazine ranks it as the top 5 business schools. There are other magazines that rank it as the 4th best. They've knocked one iron. And it's a good school in spite of people like me. For example, have you heard of Paperboat?
Yeah.
He's my MBA junior. Do you use set-top boxes in your home?
Yes.
There's a box called My Box. That's an MBA junior, and I can go down. So it's when I was studying.
Even the Evan Dust Fund guys, your
So MD of the NBFC is Michael. And Ranu and Deepak are not, but Sandeep Tapial is my MDI batchmate. So I can go on, right? There are 12,000 alumni of MDI, 9,000 PGPA, which is the main course. And 3,000 is an MP and part-time and executive. So I got in when we had a tie with Kellogg, when I was studying it, had a tie with Kellogg. And just to tell you, this year's placement in MDI are already over, last week back. The average salary is about 20 lakhs. So it's a good school, and it is over 34 or 44 acres. It's got great infrastructure, it has great faculty. Last 5 years were a little tough because we had 5 directors in 5 years, but we now have a director for 5 years. And you know, every institution has its own journey. So I went to MDI and I got a campus job in a listed IT services company called Mastec. And I was set to join that till I met a friend of mine who introduced me to his brother-in-law who was setting up Collier's Jardine. Does anybody know what's Collier's Jardine? I know you know. But real estate consulting firm. So I met David, he's an Australian who was the number two. Michael Thompson was the boss and David was the number two. And I was young and impressionable. I'm young and impressionable now also, but I'm a little more young and impressionable. So he offered me a job with Colliers. And I came back home and I told my dad, who studied at Pitts Pilani, that you know, I'm going to join Colliers Jardine. So my dad asked me, what's Colliers? So I tried to explain to him, it does property research, it does consulting, it does broking. So my dad caught on to the broking bit and he said, agar dalali karni se itna padhne likhne kya zarurat hai. So I come from, you know, my parents are academicians, I still have their blessing. And, you know, they let me be myself, so they never stopped me. In fact, last Tuesday when I was appointed on the MDI board, my parents also live near MDI. I grew up in old Gurgaon, not the new Gurgaon. And you know, I went to see them and they were very, very happy that I got onto MDI's board. So that's my journey. I worked for 4 years and then I started a company called Exchange for Media. Those who are in PR, media, communication understand the value of Exchange for Media. But simply put,
this was a new concept in 2001 when you started it?
See,
you packaged it as new?
No. In my case, I used to work for HTA. And I had a batchmate from MDI called Amit Agnihotri, who used to work for HTA. We used to watch movies together, we used to hang out together. And then Amit said to me, I have an idea, let's build a marketplace for media. So I said, it's a good idea. So we were trying to build a marketplace, a commerce one or an eBay for media. That's why.
Did you do a business plan or it happened along the way?
So we did a business plan, but you know.
And how much did your actual working match that business plan?
So what we started out with, we are not that today. We tried to build a marketplace, we failed at that because we were ahead of time. India is a very face-to-face relationship-based society. There's lots of, see also a marketplace democratizes the market for
everyone. So how did you correct your wrong decisions?
We didn't correct, there's nothing wrong or right. I mean, there is a marketplace that is needed even today.
Yeah.
So what happened is we had started a newsletter to build our own brand and we used to put original content like. So it became the homepage of everybody. And we were very narrow about media planning bank.
Yeah.
Because me and Amit came from media planning bank. And really, 20 years back, media planners controlled all marketing spends. Today, the client controls more, but media planners still have a role, but not the kind of role they used to have. So we became the homepage for everybody in marketing, advertising, media planning bank. And then we launched a weekly called Impact. Then we launched a monthly called Pitch. Then we launched a real estate magazine. So I became a media company.
How did you be different from the other people in the industry, on the media industry? How were you different? How did you create that differentiator?
We did our first event 16 years back, the annual exchange for media conclave. And you know, that really established us because we brought all the stakeholders together. And then, you know, when I went to the US, I went to UK, looked at there were similar firms, what they were doing. And then somebody from the trade came and told us, why don't we do this? And so we just kind of built on it. So every year we try and pivot, we try and add on things, we do logical things. So we're not in the business of magazines, events, website, we do all that. But we're in the business of building a community. So we built the number one community for marketing, advertising, media. And I can say with all humility, we're the pioneers, leaders. And, you know, we continue to innovate. There are other 15 players. Economic Times is copying us, recruiting from us. But we'll stay ahead.
So, one
because we have a certain DNA. And we have a neutrality, which is very important. And we as individuals, my co-founder Nawal, who really now runs the company because I spend all my time in business world. We have a certain DNA. We stay equidistant from everyone. And we've taken us a lot to come here. So, we've kind of come ground up. So, we know the industry really well, and with all humility, and you know, I don't look like pompous people, but I don't think anybody knows more people in media, advertising, marketing, communication than me in this country.
As an entrepreneur, Annurag, we all are always in the process of building great relationships, and I have always admired you, the kind of relationships that you maintain with variety of people. Friends, he not only remembers people, but he also remembers their birth dates. And he says it such confidence that the other person also recorrects whether it is the same body.
No, I'm a quizzer, so
he does it so effortlessly well. What is that extra effort that you put in to maintain this kind of relationships across multiple cities? In fact, every day morning when Dr. Annurag Batra wakes up in bed, he has to spend 2 minutes in thinking which city is waking up in. That is the frequency of travel that he does.
I primarily come to Bombay. Because
Bombay, Hyderabad.
Mostly Bombay. Hyderabad a little bit. I have some angel investments there. But let me.
How do you maintain these relationships?
You know, I'll tell you, I went to engineering school, so I have very close friends, but I hardly meet more than 2-3 of them. My real close friends, I spent really very good time with them. But, you know, the ones that are in my industry, I tend to meet them more often. So now all my friends are from my industry. So one, we are doing things with them. Second is, you know, basic communication. And then keeping your commitment. And if you have empathy, and if you have, you know, at the end of the day, we all are selfish as human beings. I'm very selfish, you're like, you know. But if we can be a little selfless and we can, you know, we can just keep our commitments. I mean, I said I'll show up, and I've shown up, you know. So, you know, also, again, I believe in prarabdha. I believe in things are preordained. We don't know, so we make efforts. You know, God, some relationships are so good, and suddenly, you know, something happens. So, you know, again, I feel whatever happens, I've got to a point where I believe whatever happens, happens for good. So I fret a lot about it for 2-3 days. So relationships are a two-way street. It cannot be one way. But one is forgiving people. Second is accepting people as they are. And third is communication. Because, you know, we tend to, you know, we want everyone like us. I'm a very responsive person. I like everybody who is responsive. But not everyone is like that. So I have to accept that not everyone will make an effort like me. you know, for me, intent matters. Nahi hua koi baat nahi. Agnelo had good intent. And you know, again, there are ways to find intent. Over a period of time, you get to know. So again, it's not, you know, accept people as they are, forgive them, because human beings are imperfect.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And third is communicate. If you do that, relationships go. And then in some cases, there are areas of mutual interest. You know, I wanted to say some things. One is, you know, my Himani, my EA, was supposed to send a PowerPoint presentation, but she didn't send it. And I wanted to say that anyway, if she had sent it, I won't use the presentation. You know why? You know why? Because PowerPoint presentations are used by people who are neither powerful nor have a point of view. I'm Agnelo's friend. So
that is the makeup story, because he didn't send it and I could not play.
No, Himani didn't. But I just also want to say that, you know, I learned something, and you know, I love this band called UB40, but the song called Higher Ground, and I won't sing, but it's called Every Day, Every Hour, I'm Learning More. The more I learn, the less I know. The less I know, the more I dig from higher ground. So one thing I want to tell you is that my motto is that learn. Second is, when you're speaking at a conference, you know, in my profile here is, he said, I was there. So, you know, I felt the same pressure that Elizabeth Taylor faced to the night of the honeymoon. You know, her eighth husband, she got married 8 times. So, but on the night of the honeymoon, the eighth husband of Elizabeth Taylor said to Elizabeth Taylor, darling, I know what I'm supposed to do, but I hope I make it interesting. So I took notes so that I could make it interesting. I want to say something before you ask. See, again, Exchange for Media luckily turned out okay. It's been profitable for 12 years. And this year we, you know, we grew 100% last 2 years. Every quarter we grew. And I don't run the company. Nawal runs. So it's Nawal's efforts. I mentor Nawal and I hope, you know, strategize and maybe 5 relationships out of the 2,000 that matter for business, kind of managed my, you know, my friends. But really, Nawal ran the company. But business world acquired 6 years back. It was loss-making. This March, it will be profitable. And I started Exchange for Media with 63 lakhs. 63 lakhs, I'm not kidding. As of last count, I'd invested 63.5 crores in business world. Most of it my investor's money, about 7 million my investor, and 2+ million my money, right? So, but this year will be profitable. So, you know, again, it's very glamorous to say and come and talk, but everything takes effort. Getting up in time and showing up takes effort. Responding to a WhatsApp takes effort. So if you're serious about something, you make efforts, it happens. My book is coming out. It's called 8 Days a Week. How many days are there in a week?
Seven.
So what did I have for breakfast?
Is my but you're right, we are wrong.
How am
because
I
your breakfast is always different.
So, you know, by the way, I discovered 2 years back, I thought the name about 4 years back. There's a John Lennon song called 8 Days. My friend Sai, who's a group CEO Network 18, was having lunch with me in Delhi. And I told him on my book, and he told, there's a song I hadn't heard, that song. But it's a metaphor for, I hire people and they ask me, so offices, how many days? So anybody asks me, I won't hire them. I like people, work-life balance, family is important. Recouping your energy is important. You know, doing whatever makes you happy is important. Taking time off is important. You can only create stuff if you are, you know, I can only, like I'm creating, last 21 days is the best time I've had. Because I have really been super focused and created spaces where I had no work, which is what creates, you know, new ideas. And so 8 days, so, you know, I tell them I work 8 days a week, which is true. I did 12 meetings last Sunday.
Absolutely.
You were there. So, and it's not work for me. I mean, I'm having fun. So it's a metaphor for loving what you do and doing what you love. So luckily God sent me into an area that I love. It's not work, content. So my book is coming out 8 days a week, and I want to talk about 2 chapters in it. One chapter is called MBA. What is the full form of? So my book is very like simple. It doesn't glorify entrepreneurship. It doesn't have jargons. And it's original. You've talked about speaking opportunities, right? Be authentic. If I try to be Agnelo, I cannot be Agnelo, right? I can be only Annurag Batra, right? So try to be authentic. Go, stay true to what you know. Be fully in it, right? And nobody can be you. So that's the uniqueness you bring to it. So one chapter is called MBA. I used to write a column for Entrepreneur magazine, so it used to be called MBA, much below average. So there is a, in that, I talk about new age careers, you know, new age entrepreneurship opportunities. It starts with the line saying, you know, don't be an MBA, be an Uber driver. Because a C class B school, you get 10,000 rupees salary, 12. But if you're an Uber owner driver, you make 30,000 rupees. So these, you know, titles are important, you know. I won't say that they're not, you know, to me, you know, people, this founder, co-founder, people will forego 5% equity. But if you call them co-founder, they're happy. It's a good formula I hit upon, right? I mean, I call them co-founder, it's okay, right? If they deserve it, I'll save some equity. It's a smart thing. So you decide you want the, I mean, titles are important. You know, if you're a father, if you're a brother, if you're a son, you know, some chairman is important. They are not saying they're not. Because, but at the end of the day, do you have substance in it? Do you have depth in it? That is more important. So it talks, in my chapter, it talks about, you know, how to create depth, how to do something that you love and continue to love it while you do it. Second is, how many of you believe in luck? I've said luck some 7 times already. Like you said, everybody has their. So I believe a lot in luck. I met Agnelo, it is luck. And I'm, you know, I don't give up. I am like I don't give up. You know, at the end of the day, my job is ideas and money. That's my job. And people. That's the most, these three are. So, and again, you know, it's not so much about money. It's about, I believe I can add value to what he's doing. And again, I don't believe in luck. So I went, I have a very close friend. He's 29. He's in his 29th year. And I met him 5+ years back, 27th November 2014 I met him. So he's been my friend for 5 years. But in 5 years I spent more time with him than anyone in my life. He's an astrologer, but he was a software developer. So he comes with me whenever he's in Delhi. We go to, so we went to this temple in Sarojini Nagar. It was the end of May, so sweltering hot. And I came out. And I have a 15.5-year-old daughter, and she's told me not to give cash to kids. You know, you papa, you cannot do that. So I came out, and there were like 18 kids, and they all wanted something from me. So I said, ice cream khaoge? So they said yes. So I took them to the ice cream, you know, hawker there, and I got them the ice cream. So I gave them the base 10 rupees ice cream. So 12 of those 18 kids took it. But 6 of them said, no, we want a cassata, we want whatever, which cost more, 35 bucks, 40 bucks, 50 bucks, some cost 20 bucks. And I tried to bully them, take this 10 rupee ice cream or I'm going to go away. And 6 of them stood their ground. Eventually, I came in and gave them the ice cream that they wanted. So I sat in the car, me and Praveen discussed, and Praveen, I wrote this piece in my weekly on advertising impact in the Good Luck issue 2 years back. I said that, you know, all the children had an ice cream in their destiny, but the ones that had made an effort to get the ice cream they wanted, got the ice cream they wanted and created a destiny for themselves. So if you're ready to walk away from something till you don't get it, you make an effort. And it's very simple. It's, in life, mostly it's like this. So, you know, I try and follow whatever. And I've struggled in BW. I ran out of money 3 times, so on and so forth, but I'm at it. And we've built something good. And I'm not trying to be a magazine. I'm a daily website. Like Exchange for Media, I've built 15 communities. Every month I launch a new community. And I want to take on ETC and BC. I want to be a daily digital business product. I don't want to be a magazine. Of course, magazine is still very valuable. It's a prime piece of real estate. It lends credibility to everything we do. So, you know, I'm building my own business model and I'm at it. And it's a tough time, but it's okay. Last thing is, you know, how many of you like reading books?
You love the last book. Huh?
Don't have the last book. But I just shared.
Mastaram ki books aise bhi allowed nahi hai. You won't know what is that.
Yeah.
But that's a bad one I have. I have a book of PJ is coming out, the better ones than that. But how many of you read this book or heard of this book called The Last Lecture?
Lecture.
I should get a royalty on the sales of this book, last 7-8 years. How many watched the video Last Lecture? So,
video I've watched.
Tell me a little bit about the guy.
Long back.
He's a professor who's teaching on the board.
Vinay, it's a new that's video.
Do you want it? Yeah. At least you write about that. He's not fibbing. Yeah, it's a professor who has a board behind him.
Yeah.
So he died 8 years back. His name was Randolph Posh, Randy Posh. He was the world's number one professor on artificial intelligence at the Carnegie Mellon University. He was 49 when he died. He had 3 kids and a wife.
And he didn't know that he did the last lecture.
Oh, he knew.
He knew?
Yes, he knew. Oh. So one day he was diagnosed with terminal pancreatic cancer and his doctor told him that he has 6 months to live. And I'm not using the word 6 months to die. So he, at the Carnegie Mellon University of this tradition, when you're passing out, you do a last lecture to your stakeholder, to the professors, to students, to companies you consult with, because in America they allow you to consult, unlike Indian B schools. And he did this last lecture. It also happened to be his wife's birthday. And I want you to watch that video if you like self-development tools, and I would call it a self-development tool. It's a 1 hour, 10 minute lecture. If you watched it thrice, if you liked it first time, and there's a good chance you may, you will watch it again and again. But I am a little old-fashioned, so I like reading books. So I read the book first and then watched the lecture. And I would have shown a 4 minute clipping from the Oprah Winfrey show. When Oprah got to know about him, she invited him on her show. And there are 4 things that are in my book, and I talk about how I relate with them. The first thing is, I want to ask you, is there a Silicon Valley in India? Agnelo, has Silicon Valley?
No.
Why? We are a culture that only celebrates success. Have you, if somebody failed at their venture, have you ever invited a guy who did not do well in his venture?
That is going to be my next guest.
Yes. You have. See, in Silicon Valley, if you fail, they'd give you money. As long as you didn't go to Vegas and did a $40 million party, and blew the $40 million, and then you did something in Cannes and blew another $100 million. That's another story. But if you fail for some reason, you know, failure is a badge of honor. You get more money. You know, it looks good on your CV. Right? So we have not built a... I've never heard my wife telling my kids, oh, you can fail. I never heard my parents telling me and my sister and their admissions, you can fail. In fact, you know, we did okay in studies, and I, again, not a big fan of people saying, oh, I dropped out of college. And I tell you my funny story. I bought Business World. I signed the deal on 26th October. First business purchase agreement on 19th September 2013. 26th October, I gave the money. And I started running from 1st Jan 2014. And I'd done a deal with a very close friend of mine, who I'll introduce you, he's still a friend of mine, to give me about $5.5 million. Then I dealt with him culturally and I said my absent resume number. Bob. And he, like 6 months, he put lots of pressure. He's a very big guy. But I like stood by the pressure and God helped me. And then I needed money, so I was trying. Finally, Rana Kapoor invested in me in his personal capacity. And
Rana Kapoor is the guy whose bank says yes.
Yes.
Yeah, we don't know what to talk about. But anyway, God bless him, and I always stay grateful. So I came from this meeting. So my final meeting, I brought my CEO, who lives in DEFCON, to R.S. Ahuja, and I really look up to him, said Arjit. And we met the right-hand man of Rana Kapoor, a guy called Varun Kapoor. And because I was speaking to May, if I go back to 19th May, and I was speaking at this conference by Mr. Salun K, SME Chamber.
Chandragant Salun.
So he had Montek Singh Aluwalia, he is the Marshall Karsav, he had the L&T chairman. And for some reason, I was the keynote speaking before them. And I was speaking on economics where Montek Singh Aluwalia is sitting. So I tell you, I flew in. We went to... it's a really funny story, okay? And all my stories are real. No exaggeration, no bullshit. So I came with my CN. You know, we were talking about valuation. There's an Indian restaurant in the Sofitel. We had dinner there. And then I was... Last 3, 4, 5 months, I was stressed. I'd taken debt, and in my business, this first business exchange from India, we are always cash flow positive and really do well. So we never needed money. So I mean, we've never sold equity, we've not taken debt. We built the business ground up. So I've taken debt, and it's a big play, and I have no money for 5 months. And finally, I'm reaching a deal, so I'm very relaxed. So I go to sleep, and I oversleep. Next day I'm speaking at 10. After many days, I'm happy that the deal is about to happen. Maybe I overslept. And I don't do my packing. My Shankar does. So he packed, and I had a new bag. So he packed some of my formal clothes. in a different compartment, you know, it's a small bag, but there's two compartments. And when I got up, I realized 9:45, my talk is at 10:15. So I quickly got ready and I'm trying to find my clothes. I'd opened it, so I can't find my clothes. So I'm wearing a t-shirt and a jeans, and I can only find my sneakers. So I have two sets of clothes always. And for 5 minutes, I find, then I finally go. And I think of it being disrespectful. There was time to wear a tie and this, and sometimes I still do. But I went there, and I haven't made my presentation. So Ram Jalan used to be head of my digital. Ram has made my economic presentation. I'm not an expert in economics. Let me tell you, I understand. And now I have better appreciation, but this was 6 years back. And I'm the first speaker. So I look at the presentation, I junk it, and I talk about how economics, entrepreneurship is related. And it did really well. In fact, that became the theme. So in the tea break at 12, there is about a 25-year-old boy comes to me, says, I really like you. I think you are like Steve Jobs, your dad. Did you drop out of school? So next 1 hour, I killed the dad. I told him, don't go by this. You know how this happened? I didn't find my clothes. And this presentation I hadn't made. So people make lots of judgments about people. They're often wrong. We meet somebody for 5 minutes, and because we stereotype, we judge, So there are lots of funny things, and some I'll tell you offline when you buy me a meal. But I want to close and then you can ask me.
No, so we want to get into a rapid question and answer.
Go ahead.
We'll start with that.
And
so
you talk about learning. I want to say, I invested in a Hyderabad case company. We're looking for master franchises in Bombay. It's called Thick Shake Factory. It's Cavinters in Bera, 130 stores. We've only closed 2 stores till today. He's in Bombay because we took wrong locations and wrong franchises. He's 31, Yashwant, who's built the company, is his company. There's a process of reverse mentoring. Not only they learn from me, or we can learn from anyone. But I learned from when I met you, I learned some things from you. How he told me the deal he had with CNBC. I wanted to give him the best media buyer of the year award. Right? I mean, I don't know who did the deal in CNBC. They should have been fired. Right? But I know who did the deal. So she's a friend of mine. But I'm just saying that there's a process of reverse mentoring. I invest in one company a year, very little money, but my name. And if I can add value, which means I can get them customers. Because at the end of the day, you raise money to get customers. Why do you need capital? To build a product, people, or to get your customers, acquisition of customers. So there is in my book, there's a chapter on reverse mentoring. There are 5-6 young people I met. Somebody was 18. His name is Ashish Birgi. He's in my book. So I learned a lot from him. I mean, I met him when he was 18. He's 28 now. He's been my friend. So I have a chapter on reverse mentoring. So all of us can learn from each other. And I don't talk about cliches. I'm not into cliches. I really, every person I meet, I learn something from them. And some I learn what not to do. But those are not mentioned in my book.